May I request Dr. T.R. Ahlawat sir to please present the memento to Dr. S.R. Chaudhary, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of the University. And the memento itself is made up of non-timber forest product. May I also request him to present the memento to Dr. C.S.P. Patil. I call on Dr. R.P. Gunagar to present the memento to Dr. R. Vasudeva.
That is called as a mass extinction, and these have become extinct in relatively very short period of time. Just to go to you very quickly, there are five such episodes that have been identified in the last 500 million years. The very recent one being around 80 million years back. The famous one is actually the Jurassic era, where because of a comet or something, there was a mass extinction of the dinosaurs.
In case of medicinal plants, cultivation is the only, the only option left. Because harvesting from the wild is almost prohibited. And the second thing is that the uniformity, what we see in case of cultivating these medicinal plants, so that can be obtained and we can go for that.
It is our strength to know that medicinal plants are being used various systems of medicines. If you can see that our indigenous systems of medicine such as Ayurveda, Unani, Homeopathy, Naturopathy and Amethi, all these are dependent on medicinal plants for their raw drugs, and in from the raw drugs they make various formulations to treat various ailments of human beings as well as animals.
Advances in utilization, processing, value addition starts with the topic, starts with the theme that we all collectively have to understand what a medicinal plant is. Herbal powders, powders of ashwagandha, as I was talking, stevia, for instance, plantago, all they give much more acceptability in the market because the consumer finds it much more easier to consume it.
Considering the audience, especially students, because Northeast region, you all know, it's totally different from this part. So I thought that you must be familiar with some of the important medicinal plants of Northeast region, which helps in the livelihood security as well as nutritional security of the peoples living there.
500 million straws are used every day in the US. In this country, mainly the use of straw is very high. Even they have calculated upon a minute that 1.6 straws are used every minute in the US. So we can take this lateral branch. It has no use in bamboo products also. So we can use this lateral branch, and in between its internodes, we can use this part as a straw.
So this is a, so these, like this, we take the gums, then we convert it into strips. We remove the outer and inner layer that hinders the adhesion. Then this is our hot press in which we place the strips inside, and from both the sides, that is from horizontal, like this horizontal, this is a special assembly which was made in our institute, through which the horizontal pressure is applied and the hot press is vertical pressure is applied, so as to remove the gaps and any other defects which are present in bamboos.
Some of the innovative products that we developed under NAHP CAST includes the wall hanging stands, then multi-dimensional multifarious pen stands, peacock stand that is prepared from bamboo, as well as utilizing the inflorescence of the coconut. And it was one of the key attractions during the review meeting under NAHP CAST at New Delhi, and has been apprised both the ND and NC during that this thing. This is a stump decorate, that is prepared out of the waste, otherwise we used to burn or throw in the forest floor. These are some of the other decorates, the contemporary decorates prepared out of the raw material. This is the wooden block, and this is the climber, that and these are prepared from the wood, and this is the flower of the devadar cone, and these are being used to give an appropriate luster and attractive decorates to prepare. Wood stamp decorates, that these are the other some, and this is also one of the important, and you get a premium price by preparing the bamboo waterfall. It is also been exhibited during the review meeting at NAHP.
Basically, the Safed Musli is Chlorophytum species, which are industrially used. And for example, my the other quantum information gained from Ayurveda and other Sanskrit literature. For example, my name is Minal, and there is one sir in our college. His name is also Minal. So vernacular species are different, but names are same. So that there might be a chance of confusion. So above two mentioned points, there is a result in adulteration and substitution.
My topic is eucalyptus bark and branchwood biomass as a source of renewable energy. See, energy plays a very pivotal role in our life. Without energy, we can't do anything. Nothing. Neither our vehicles will run, nor the instruments, nor equipments, and very personal level, we will not be able to charge our mobile, and we will not be able to have our selfies. Energy is there everywhere in your life. We are handicapped, we are helpless without energy.
I thank Dr. Ravindra Raina sir, Dr. T.R. Alawat sir for acting as a chair and co-chair, and also thank Dr. S.T. Hegde and Rajveer Singh Chauhan for acting as a rapporteurs and smoothly holding the session, sir. During these sessions, Dr. Ravindra Raina sir also delivered a lead lecture on advances in processing, utilization and value addition of MAPs. In this context, to make this event more memorable, I request Dr. R.P. Gunaga sir to hand over a memento to Dr. Ravindra Raina sir. I also request him to give a memento to Dr. T.R. Alawat sir, PI and Nodal Officer, for acting as a co-chair. I also request him to give a memento to Dr. T.S. Mehra sir for delivering a lead lecture on medicinal and aromatic plant resources of northern states of for nutritional and livelihood security. I also request him to pass on the memento to Dr. Nandakishore sir for delivering a lead lecture on processing and value addition of natural gums and resins.